OMG, OMG, OMG. Once again, it's on CES 2020. Vegas, baby. Stay tuned for a few suggestions, for a few tips, if you plan to partake on today's Renewable Rechargeable Review.
It's the Renewable and Rechargeable Review with the RSI guy.
Hey everybody, welcome to the Renewable Rechargeable Review. It's me, the RSI guy. And today we are going to talk about CES 2020. A few tips, a few suggestions that maybe can help you navigate, see more, do more, and have a overall enjoyable experience if you are attending. So, let's get it rolling, shall we? First of all, you're going to need your badge, which you can get at not only the LVCC, the Las Vegas Convention Center, but many hotels along the strip. They have sections and booths set up that you can check in, show your credentials, and receive your badge. You put that badge on, and you got to wear it at all times to get in and out of the events and for any nighttime activities. Now, once you get your badge, which you can do before the show starts, like the day before, the evening before, or the day of, you're good to go. Now, remember, when you go into the events, if you do carry a bag, there will be security to make sure you're good to go. You don't have anything nefarious in there. And then you're good. Now, on being prepared for the day's activities, it's a very good idea to know what you want to do, because CES, it takes up the entire convention center, all the floors, the lots adjoining. It takes the Sands Convention Center, you know, both floors. It's massive. Thousands and thousands of square feet, thousands and thousands of people. Even if you huffed it and went straight through and just glanced at everything, it's likely you won't see it all. So go to the app, which there is for Android and iOS. You can look at the companies, you can look at what they put out, and you can decide how you want to navigate, what you want to see. You want to see the, you know, the TVs that are, you know, as big as a barn? Do you want to see the stereo equipment? Do you want to see the new AI? Do you want to see the new drones? You know, do you want to see the international area, you know, where it's more manufacturing and knockoffs? Or one of my favorite spots, the up-and-comers, the startups, where they take over, I believe it's the Sands downstairs, and they don't have the big booth spaces, you know, of the Dells, of the Microsofts, of the world, and et cetera. They're in there grimy, elbow to elbow. It's like, yo, this is the product that we came up with. Those are the things I'm excited to see, the new stuff, the you know, the stuff that doesn't have a booth after booth after booth of the same type materials or the same type products, gadgets, gizmos. So once you have that plan in hand, it will allow you to see more and do more and wisely spend your time. Now, on that subject of spending your time, you have to get to and from the convention center. The hours, are, I believe, are 9 to 5 or 8 to 5 or 8 to 4. You know, your typical daytime hours. You can look it up when you get there. Don't quote me. But they do have shuttle buses that stop at most major hotels along the strip. But there are only so many of them. And they run, I believe it's 2 hours before start up until like an hour after this the convention's over for the day. They do not run all day, just in the morning and at night or the evening. And they will be crowded because thousands of people are going to be there. So if you are able to get the shuttle bus, which is free, you hop on there, you get out early, you know, go get them. And then you're at the convention center all day, and then you hop a shuttle bus at night. Now, in the interim, they're the ride-sharing programs. You got your Uber, you got your Lyft, you got your taxis. And then there's the, is it the monorail? Metro rail? It's the rail system there in Vegas. It's only one of them. You can't miss it. And it connects to a lot of the strip hotels as well. Now, if you stand off the strip, you know, that's ride sharing, that's taxi, that's walking. You're going to get your steps in, no doubt. Now, before you want to do that, I suggest a nice hearty breakfast. And that way you can skip lunch. You can take up, you know, a couple pieces of fruit with you, little bags of trail mix, you know, little bottles of water, because you don't want to really stop and break for lunch, because if you do, they're going to get taxed. And the taxation works this way. If you eat at the convention center after standing in that long line of other people who are eating at the convention center, most of them because they have booths there and they can't leave, you know, a little bottle of water is like $10, a bag of chips, $8. You know, it's ridiculous because of the just the taxes of being in a convention. You know, that happens any place and every place. And then also you have the fact that if you want to leave the convention center, go get some lunch and then come back. You know, so that's travel time, that's eating time, that's time away from seeing the exhibits, seeing the devices, seeing the gadgets, seeing the gizmos. Can't have that. So take a snack with you after you have a nice hearty breakfast, and you should be good until dinner time. Because like I said, it closes up, you know, 4, 5, 6 o'clock, you're good. Then you go find a buffet or whatever you want to eat. I mean, it is Vegas, so there's going to be food. Have a backpack with you. Unless you have your own personal Sherpa, which we all, you know, should someday. If that's racist, I'm sorry. But yeah, you know, somebody to carry your stuff for you. Because it is Vegas, it's the desert, but it's January. So it gets warm in the daytime, you get up to 50, 60, 70 degrees. But then at night and in the early mornings, it's quite chilly out, you know, down in the 30s and 40s. So you want a good hoodie with you in the morning. Sometimes at the convention centers, they have the AC on, which feels awesome about, you know, 2, 3 o'clock. But 9 to 10, 11, it's like, ooh, a little chilly in here. So you want to have a hoodie, something to cover up your arms, or just a long sleeve under your t-shirt. You know, depending on how your body temperature runs, that's all individual preference. But you do want to be able to dress for the desert, but also dress for being mobile as you are walking from exhibit to exhibit, you know, from convention center to hotel or wherever you're going. You're going to get a good, you know, good lather going, good perspiration. But you don't want to be too cold, you don't want to be too hot, you don't want to carry a lot of stuff, so you don't need a winter coat, you know, you don't want to wear long underwear under your clothing, unless you're just from some very tropical place where 30 degrees is like, oh my, it's very cold. But if you're from some place where it gets cold and you have winter and snow and ice and polar vortexes, you know, it's going to be, you know, a piece of cake. Now, on that note, remember to carry hand sanitizer with you, as there will be a lot of handshaking, a lot of talking. And it is cold and flu season, so you don't want to come back with a souvenir you don't want. And along those lines, if you're going to be talking to people, which you probably will, hey, what's this all about? And asking questions. Have a couple breath mints on you, you know, for the afternoon, you know, the later times in the day. Because you brush in the morning, so you should be good to go until lunchtime. But then, you know, your breath, it gets hot. You know what I mean? It gets tart. And you don't want to be offensive to anybody. So hand sanitizer, breath mints, snacks, water, and then your camera equipment or whatever else it is you're carrying, a jacket or hoodie, and that's what's going to be most of the volume in your bag that you carry. Now, most of the exhibits have flyers or pamphlets or little brochures, magazines on what it is you're seeing or what it is they're displaying. You can carry those and get those. And usually they around the conference, they have the little tote bags that you can amass those in. Now, you may not want to take it because a lot of these exhibitors do have online resources, and you can basically download what those handouts are. And so that, you know, saves some trees, and it stops you from having to carry so much stuff because you'll collect it at the convention, but then by the time you check out your hotel for your flight home, all that stuff is going to stay there. So, you know, don't be wasteful. And think about how you can get the information that you want without having to actually get the paper copies. All right, as I look at my notes here, we got the trail mix, we got the taxation for lunch. You're going to get your steps in. Yeah. Oh, make sure you have business cards. And don't be scared to share those cards. You know, they have jars or containers at some of the exhibits. So, hey, put your business card in, you know, for a raffle. We'll give away, you know, whatever the swag, whatever the gift is. You know, put that in there. You know, do a little networking. You know, don't be shy. Don't expect a lot of, you know, free stuff, a lot of handouts, because with the amount of people going, no company could afford to pay the prices of getting a booth there, hiring people to work it, and then give away all the stuff for free. You know, so don't go in expecting it, but if you have the opportunity via one of the business card drawings or, you know, watch this video, answer these questions, we'll give you a gift at the end. You know, those type things or what have you, where you get stuff. And also, try to avoid lines as much as possible, unless it's actually something you want to stand in line for. And most of that comes when they have celebrities, you know, actors, actresses, athletes that are there, you know, the nice photo op. And it's just somebody you have to see and, you know, shake their hand, take a quick pic, and then keep it moving. But it takes time away from your viewing if you are standing in line. Be patient with accents. This is an international conference. Everyone speaks English. Some just do it better than others. So be patient. You know, be understanding. Be welcoming. You know, don't be some kind of, you know, just, well, I couldn't understand what he or she was saying. It just took away from my experience. Oh, you know, screw you. Get over it. There will be exhibitors from all four corners of the planet, from everywhere. And if you want to see and hear them, understand that they are coming from those native places, and English may not always be their first language. But understand this also. Most people that speak English, that are born speaking English as their first language, don't speak nothing else. So if you don't have the skills to go to their country and communicate, keep your mouth shut. Also for your bag when you carry it, if you're going to be taking a lot of pictures or video or capturing content for whatever use you have it for, have an extra charger, like the Interplex I did on previous content video here on the renewable rechargeable review, where it's already charged. You can just plug your device into it, your camera or your phone camera, and recharge it, or extra batteries to swap out, because you don't want to get there in the middle of the day and now you don't have any juice and you have this cord trying to find an outlet someplace. It's not a good look. I think I covered most of the things I want to cover today, because for those of you who are going for the first time, you don't know what to expect, you're excited, you don't know what to bring, you don't know what to pack. Hopefully these few tips, suggestions can help you out, because the multitude of products are going to be there. You know, your IoT of things, Internet of Things, your 5G tech, your see-through TVs, I want to see what the new AI is. Because I'm telling you, I've said this before, I'm on record. Very soon, law enforcement will not be what we are used to. It's not going to be, I don't think, RoboCop stages just yet. But a lot more AI and a lot more robotics and a lot more drones are going to be out policing our streets. And I want to see what kind of advancements they've made since last year on that. So download the app, see what companies are going to be there, see what the products are, map out your daily schedule, get good sleep. You want to get up, you know, 6:30 in the morning, you know, shower up, get your hygiene right. You want to get a little something to eat, then you want to hit the conference, and then you want to be at the conference all day. Now, I wouldn't suggest a nap after the conference, because then that may throw you off, and now you're up till 2 in the morning. Unless there is a evening activity, you know, check Eventbrite, or while you're networking through the day, you may, you know, hook up with some people, and they're like, hey, we're throwing a function, or we have an event, or join me for a drink or dinner. And that's going to be, you know, 7-8 o'clock. So by the time you get back to your room, you might want to freshen up a little bit and then go out for the evening. But you want to have your ass back in bed by midnight, or, you know, at least close to it, because it is Vegas, baby, and it goes 24/7. You want to burn a candle at both ends like that, more power to you. But once you get a little longer in the tooth, like some people, you know, you gotta get some sleep. You know, so be in bed by 11:30, 12 o'clock, you know, let that body rest up for another day of hitting it, all right? So make sure that if you are there and you see your boy, you know, holla, what's up? And just, you know, have a good time. Safety-wise, you know, always remain vigilant no matter where you are. This is no different. But understand that if you do have that badge on walking around in public, you know, the ne'er-do-wells, local ne'er-do-wells may know that, hey, there's an out-of-towner, you know, let me see what's up with them. Are they paying attention to their surroundings? You know, are they aware of things going on? You know, you don't want to be a victim like that. Other than that, hey, just have a good time. Enjoy the experience. You know, this is the Super Bowl of conventions for electronics, gadgets, gizmos, all of that stuff. You know, what's going to happen at the LVCC, at the Sands, are what people are going to be talking about for the next year. All of the websites, all of the blogs, all of the vlogs. You know, that's what the content's going to be. And you have the opportunity to be there in person. All right? So remember, as always, you know the rules. Subscribe. And a little note on that. I don't have the numbers yet. I'm still nascent in the biz, you know, to be that, you know, influencer of influencers. But help me help you by subscribing and get those numbers up. And, you know, share these videos. Comment, you know, pro, con, negative, positive. It's all good. And visit the website, rsigreenenergynetwork.org. Twitter, which really scares me to use, because I'm going to type something, somebody going to take it wrong, and then it's going to be a big misunderstanding. But I'm there, Guy RSI. And on Facebook, RSI Green Energy Network. All right? So if you do go, be safe, have fun, and just enjoy all the new stuff. Like, ooh, I'm excited! Vegas, baby! CES 2020. It's about to go down. All right? So, until next time, have a good one, y'all.